told you I got you.
Resolution Sports, the number one source, breaking from football up to extreme sports. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution.
Ready to go. Getting a little antsy, getting excited.
Is it good to fight someone near your size for once?
Yeah, but I mean, somebody my size poses a different problem. You know what I mean? It becomes, now I gotta deal with the fact that he's gonna throw more punches, they move more, and it becomes a more difficult target.
You feel this fight is the winner gets back to in the same for Klitschko, and the loser, like they said, maybe time to get your fishy pole?
Kind of, in a sense, but. I think even a loser in a fight like this, where you have two really well-known fighters, even in a loss, close decision or something like that, loss, or even in a knockout loss, depending on how the situation looks, there's a chance. Of course, nobody wants to deal with that, but there's still a chance.
You feel that, and the same thing goes for him. I think each of you guys are fighting maybe a little bit more desperate, knowing what the stakes are in this fight.
Because it's important to be able to win. You know what I mean? You don't want to take a loss in a situation like this. And every fight is a must win, and this more than others.
Talk about Detroit and going out there.
Oh man, you heard. 150 degrees. No matter where you go in the Trump gym, and when you leave out, it can be 80 degrees outside, and it feels cold. So that tells you how difficult the days were in there, and sparring in that kind of those kind of conditions.
Anything we're seeing closing?
So all the people just come out and watch it. It's going to be an epic night. A lot of people are going to really enjoy it, and maybe want to see something like this again.
See you Saturday night.
All right.
And now, Eddie, when you were in Detroit, aside from the conditions that you were training and everything, being away from your home and everything, kind of mentally, kind of put you in a different place as well. Can you kind of speak about that a little bit?
Well, I think being away from home kind of gets you just focused on what you're doing. You know what I mean? See, at home sometimes you can be a little bit too loose and have a little too much fun, and take a little bit too much time away from what you're trying to do. But in a camp atmosphere like that, it becomes all business, all work, not too much play. I mean, you still post weekends or whenever your day's off, you kind of chill it off a little bit. But when we're talking about work days, all work days. And you're not thinking about anything but, I'm talking about video study, whether sparring, conditioning, strength, whatever. It's all, pushed to one goal, and that's about winning the fight.
Now, I'm sure you're probably aware too, but back back home in Philly, there was a lot of anticipation and hype that's been building, obviously from your supporters and following, but really excited about this fight. And when you came back home to Philly from the camp, before you came up to get ready for the fight, how was the homecoming?
Well, I'm sorry.
Take your time.
I'm sorry. Say it again. What question was?
Just kind of talking about, there was a lot of anticipation in Philadelphia for when you got home. And can you kind of speak to me a little bit about that homecoming when you came back from camp?
Well, actually, when I came to camp, I came directly to Newark. But I mean, I'm still close to home. And I'm pretty sure when I get to see the people that I've supported for so long, family, friends, and even people from my gym, it's gonna be a great homecoming, man, especially with a victory. I'm certain it's gonna be the kind of homecoming. I don't know if I'm gonna get a parade or anything, but at least I might get a little bit of love on the back end.
Do you think your layoff has been a positive or a negative?
It can be construed as both. I mean, it depends on who wins the fight. You know what I mean? If I go out there and win, then it's like, because he needs that time off. He's done a lot, done even really well. But if I go in and lose, like, he needed a warm up, he needed a tune up, he needed something. So that's all, remains to be seen. I think, in my opinion, that it gave me time to reflect, understand certain things about my career, business-wise, and also, physically inside the ring as well. You know what I mean? I got a chance to really look over some things. Now I think I got a better understanding of where I'm going. You know what I mean? Had a lot of film study as far as the physical part of the ring and to understand what I have to do to get better.
Ron Briggs from Boxing.com, how you doing? Just a couple of questions for you. After taking such a long period of time off, was there any consideration about possibly taking maybe a lesser opponent than a former? champion?
Honestly, I thought of it. You know what I mean? I thought of it even when we were talking in discussions about actually fighting with Tomas. I said, well, let's get another fight in. Knock some of the rust off. If there's any going to be any there, at least I'll have the opportunity to do that in a fight before this. But it was voiced to me that we don't know if you'll ever be able to get this opportunity again. And it's a shot. And I said, you know what? Okay. And I think a tune-up would have been good, of course. But I mean, it's okay. Because I've done this 38 other times. You know what I mean? If I don't know it by now, I'm not going to do it. So.
What kind of sparring were you able to get in Detroit?
A lot of great sparring. Great sparring. I had a guy that actually faced Tomas years ago, Jonathan Banks, that I work with, as well as guys, lighterweight guys like Bruno Rodriguez, Don George, a guy by the name of Hollywood, Aaron Pryor Jr., different flavors of guys. All of them have elements of what Tomas brings to the table, but different, you know what I mean? And it's all, they're all getting in the ring fresh, so I'm like, I'm exhausted fighting with them, but it helps. And then I had big guys too. I had a young friend of mine who actually is a really good fighter, Ricardo Wallers, come in, give me some great rounds, as well as, Jonathan Banks is heavyweight. So. And there were some other guys that were around the gym who you wouldn't even know of that came in and gave me some great rounds. So, like I said, I prepared. I've done everything possible to be great.
How long were you there, Eddie?
5 to 6 weeks.
6 weeks?
5 or 6 weeks.
5 or 6 weeks.
You know what I mean? Pushed every week that I was there. You know what I mean? Just put a lot of rounds in. A lot of focus on what we're doing tonight. Not tonight. Saturday night.
Ready to do it tonight.
Is it frustrating that the Klitschko brothers have kind of dominated the heavyweight picture? I mean, this is a big fight, but it's flying under the radar.
I can appreciate the success. Yeah, they're from another country and everything, but I can appreciate that success. I mean, if I was on top, I'm pretty sure in their country they would be upset about it. Not really, they love boxing over there. Why in America, just because guys from another country is dominating, they just don't love the sport anymore? It's just not fair. I think it goes into the arrogance a little bit of the American people. I love America, I'm from here. You know what I mean? And I don't want to go anywhere, I don't want to live anywhere else. But I think this sport has been around so long and has given so many great things to entertainment to the fans, that I just think that we need to get a little more interested. So the fact that the Klitschko brothers are dominating and doing all that great stuff is just another feather in the cap of the sport. I think that people here just need to get on the bandwagon a little bit. Not necessarily with the Klitschko, but if you don't like them, you don't like them.
Yeah.
But look at us. We're still out here. We're still here.
In this building, yeah, we innovating. Cleaning out the half knots, yeah, we renovating. You already lost, man, I see you fading. Them lightning bolts.